Live a life that is worthy of a ministry. Live a life that can attract somebody.
Do you desire to be fruitful? The qualification for fruitfulness is that you must
abide in him.
That is a casting down. You will announce that there is a lifting up. This is the year. 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 Yeah. This is a year. Do you agree with me that this is a year? Huh? This year, with the covenant I have with God, God will put a parcel in the hand of somebody. The mouth of your enemy will shut off. Toknadu family, as you listen to the sound of my voice today, I enter into covenant with you. By the reason of the call of God over my life, you, under this unction and grace, 2017 is a pay year. It must pay you. It must pay you. It must pay you. It must pay you. Somebody shout amen. I told you before that everything in life is turn by turn. And when it is your turn, everything will turn to you. Ladies and gentlemen, without apologies to anybody, 2017 is the turn of the family of the God of Toknadu. Say it anywhere, I said so. Say it anywhere, I said so. In 2017, God will so bless us that even our enemies, we say we don't like them, but they are blessed. This year, they will confess. In your family, they will confess. In your compound, they will confess that your God is better than their God. If you believe me, let your amen come 3 times. Wherever you are, all over the world, hear me as I say what he told us. The Bible said at the last day, when we appear in heaven, we will sit according to families. Now, what he said to one family is not what he's saying to another family. Every family is peculiar to the covenant they have with God. And God treats them according to the covenant God has with them. And for the Toknadu family, he asked me to declare, this is our year of unstoppable rewards.
It is my turn to shine.
It's our year of unstoppable reward.
Now rise and shine.
Nothing will stop you anymore.
It is my turn. It is my turn. It is my turn to
this
shine.
This is our year of unstoppable reward.
It is my turn to shine. Allah will rise and shine.
This is our year of unstoppable reward.
It is my turn. It is our turn to shine. It is your turn to shine. Turn to shine. And you rise and shine. It is your
stop
it. It is my turn to shine.
Bible-believing mission incorporated, the dwelling place of the God of Talking and Truth.
Let me tell you what God is going to do for the Talking and Truth family this year. Everything in other years denied you, 2017 will reward you for it. Whatever other years took away from you, this is the year that will reward you for them. And you know what God told me? He said the reward is unstoppable. That is to say, any man may stand against it, but they can't stop it. Any man can fight against it, but they can't stop it. It must enter your hands. It must enter your life. Lift your voice and shout amen like you mean it. Oh yeah, sit down but don't go down. Sit like a king and a queen. This year is taking you somewhere. I'm sure of what I'm saying. The year is taking you somewhere. Every breeze that will touch you this year is a different breeze altogether. There are some things you don't need to fight. The year will fight it. This year is going to fight the enemy from coming near your dwelling. The year will fight it. Come, how many of you are feeling what I'm feeling? 2017 is telling somebody, you're welcome. Come on, you're welcome. Welcome, you're welcome. You're welcome. They pursued you, but you're welcome. They were chasing you, but you're welcome. 2016 was not fair to you, but you're welcome. 2017 is telling you, I'm a safe ground. You're welcome. I'm a land of refuge. You're welcome. I'm a land of safety. You're welcome. You made it to 2017. I salute you. What a people. Between now and the end of the first quarter of 2017, by the time we gather here for worship, you will feel the difference. This is prophecy. It shall come to pass. If you shout your amen better, I will feel better. Somebody was sick before. Nobody prayed for you. You just got well. 2017. In 2017, brother, I'm coming with double hammer. Double hammer. Hear me? I said this is a year God told me that for us this is a year of unstoppable reward. Now hear me. This year I'm coming with double hammer. If you touch my own, I hammer you. Announce it aloud. That is what I said, and I will keep to my word. I carry the prophetic mandate of the God of Talking and Doing. This year, I will not take it. Touch my own, you hear, Agba. One more time. Show love to somebody. I like to talk, but show love to somebody. Show love to somebody. This year, your face will open doors. Your hands will hold favor. Genesis 41. Are you there? Genesis 41, verse 14.
Then Pharaoh sent and called Joseph.
Father, thank you. Your word is power. The Bible said that the entrance of your word giveth light and it giveth understanding to the simple. Let your word in 2017 2017 become the work that will war out our wars. Become the word that will prove to our world that your word is worded in our world. Let your word do for us what we cannot do for ourselves. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Then Pharaoh said.
Then Pharaoh sent.
And called unto Joseph.
And called unto Joseph.
And they brought him hastily out.
And they brought him out. Not just that they brought him out, but they brought him out in a haste.
Out of the dungeon.
Out of the dungeon. I have overstayed in the dungeon, brother. My sister have overstayed in the dungeon. My brother have overstayed in the dungeon. There is a voice calling my name. In 2017, a voice is calling me. A voice higher than the one that put me in the dungeon. A voice higher than the one that put me down. A voice higher than the one that shamed me down. He's calling me out of the dungeon.
And he shaved himself.
And he said to himself.
And changed his raiment.
He shaved himself and changed his garments.
And came in unto Pharaoh.
And he came in unto Pharaoh. Hold on, sir. And he came in unto Pharaoh. Close your Bible, son. You hear me? Few minutes. Verse 14 of Genesis chapter 41 started with the word then. Then talks about at that time. At that point, it gets to a point in the life of a man when it is no more your struggle that will carry you. And that's the point where we are. I came to talk to somebody, not everybody. What I'm about to say this morning, it's not everybody that will understand me, but somebody for whom I'm sent, you will understand me, because the Bible said that in the days of his power, his people shall be willing. It didn't happen the day before. It didn't happen the month before. Every man has a time set by God for your remembrance. And when that time comes, it becomes your day. The Bible said, then Pharaoh sent for him. Ladies and gentlemen, anytime the night becomes terrible, the morning will be favorable. Little wonder my Bible said that weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. If the word of God be true that it is, anytime the night is terrible, then the morning is favorable. Anytime the year becomes a struggling year, watch out, the coming year becomes a supplying year. 2016 was tough. 2016 knocked many down and out. But look at you. In the midst of all of the battle, you're still shining. If you can shine in 2016, what will you do in 2017?
Then, at that time, when 2017 arrives, every hidden treasure, God unfolds them, releases them, and hands them over to men who are his own. Then, my Bible said, then, at that time, at that point, at that time, when was the day? Ladies and gentlemen, the day they put Joseph in prison was not the day that Pharaoh remembered him. There are people who didn't know your name. There are people who doesn't know your home address. There are people who have not heard about you. There are people who doesn't know your phone number. But when your day appears, they will know you. And this is your day. I'm talking to somebody and you're not shouting here. I'm prophesying over your life and you're not shouting in this house. I said, this is your day. This is your day.
This is your den. This is your den. Then Pharaoh sent for Joseph. Ladies and gentlemen, Joseph, as at the time Pharaoh sent for him, was in prison. But Pharaoh sent for him. But I'm a student of the Bible. I understood something as I read the scripture. When Pharaoh was sending for Joseph, Pharaoh never asked for his offense. You didn't hear me? When Pharaoh was sending for Joseph, the right thing, humanly talking, would have been, this man I want to send for, what was his offense? But shall I say this to you? The Bible declared that God of heaven said, I will have mercy upon whom I will have mercy. Anytime God is ready to remember you, he will not talk about your offense. He will not talk about what you have done. He will not talk about what you have not done. So it is not by merit, it is by favor. When Pharaoh was sending for him, Pharaoh never demanded for his case file. Pharaoh never said, bring his case file. Let me see what he has done and know whether he is qualified to enter the palace. No. Ladies and gentlemen, in 2017, God will not ask you for your background. God will not ask you for your antecedents. God will just move ahead and shower you favor on every side. 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 I'm describing 2017. Somebody, you don't have to be quiet now. This is a prophetic time. This is a prophetic house. As I release the word, heaven is releasing it. As I speak it, for God is confirming it. As the word comes over your head, God! God! God is confirming his word. When Pharaoh was sending for Joseph, Pharaoh didn't demand for his case file. Number one, Pharaoh never asked, who does he have the case with? Eh? So it doesn't matter how many people sitting on your file. When God steps into your matter, the person sitting on your file becomes immaterial. Am I talking to somebody now? I don't care who is presiding over your case. Anytime God steps into your case, the one presiding over the case becomes a nobody, because God is the superintendent of all flesh. Am I talking to you now? He superintends over the affairs of all men. No one can talk when God talks. No one can counter God's judgment. In the court and judgment of God, there is no appeal. Ladies and gentlemen, they put him in prison, passing through the process. So before he would get to prison, he must have gone to court. And then from the court, they sent him to prison. But when Pharaoh was removing him, Pharaoh did not ask which judge is presiding over the matter. Pharaoh said, go and call him. 2017, he's saying, go and call her. Go and call him. I'm talking to somebody. Is that person in this house? 2017 is saying, call him, call him. Call her, call her. Call him, call him. Call her, call her. Call her out. The time has come. Call him out. The time has come. It is a time of favor. It is a time of lifting. It is a time of promotion. It is a time of increase. I don't care who said what. I don't care who did what. When it is your turn, you become unstoppable. 2017 sent me to somebody. I don't know if that person is in this house. If you're in this house, shout like I am. Are you ready?
Yes,
then, at that time, Pharaoh sent for Joseph. When Pharaoh sent for Joseph, ladies and gentlemen, remember they told him he was in prison. The next question is, What did he do? But Pharaoh never asked. Because when God wants to favor you, he will not ask questions. God will not make inquiry from anybody. Whatever it is that put you there, God is not interested. I came to announce to somebody, congratulations, you're coming out. That amen is not born again. Come on! You're coming out. 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 You're coming out.
Ladies and gentlemen, there is something I saw in that passage of the scripture, in that one verse, that touched my heart, and I will start rounding up from there. Ladies and gentlemen, what is it that I saw? I saw then Pharaoh sent for Joseph. Now, when they went for Joseph, I saw something touching. The Bible said when they went for Joseph, they brought him out in a haste. You know what that means? They brought him out in a hurry. Shall I say this to you? 2017 will bless you in a hurry. I'm talking to somebody. 2017 will bless you in a hurry. Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. 2017 will bless you in a hurry. While you are talking of one blessing, another blessing is coming. You're talking about that blessing, another one is hitting you. Bah, 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 bah. The blessings of the Lord will overtake you in 2017. They brought him out in a hurry. Why were they bringing him out in a hurry? They were bringing him out in a hurry because his time has come. Oh, 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 oh. Every door that owe you will pay you. Every door. Every door that owe you will pay you. Every door that owe you will pay you. This is 2017, brother. He sent me to tell you that this year you are not permitted to cry. Ladies and gentlemen, I saw something in that passage of the scripture. The Bible said they went in and they were bringing him out in a hurry. Then I asked myself, doesn't he have legs? Doesn't he have hands? They could have as well told him, Joseph, you are free to come out. No, they don't know if he was going to delay. So they were in a hurry. So they used their own hand to hold him and say, come out from there. This year, those who put you down will be the same people to lift you up. Those who criticize you, they will publicize you. Those who mocked you, they will make a name for your God. You will find what you're looking for. I didn't hear your amen like thunder. This year, you're coming in contact with this anointing. We put big smiles on your face. What they said will not happen in your life over the years. They said you won't settle down. But hear me, this year, you will not only settle, but you will be happy. Amen. I have spoken. This is the prophecy for you in 2017. I don't care your age. What I have said will happen with speed. Amen. Ladies and gentlemen, the same people, I followed up the story of Joseph. And the Bible history told me that when they were sending him to the prison, they never sought for his opinion. Immediately, Potiphar's wife said her own. That was all.
They believed Potiphar's wife and sent him to prison. Right inside the prison, when his time came, nobody spoke for him. He never spoke. I never saw the Bible declare that he had an advocate. I never saw the Bible declare that he had anybody speaking for him. He had nobody speaking for him. But when his time came, ladies and gentlemen, don't tell me about connections. You may not have any connection, but there is God in heaven. Once you are connected to him, he can connect you anywhere. I didn't hear your email. Once you're connected to him, he can connect you anywhere. And listen, God's connection supersedes the connections of men. God's connection is superior to the connections of men. And I hear God declare in this house that somebody under the influence of my voice, God is connecting you to become a collector of favor. God is connecting you to become a collector of favor. They brought him out in a haste. When they brought him out in a haste, they never told him how long he was going to stay. But there is something about the story of Joseph that Joseph was aware of. Joseph is aware of the fact that anytime I change my coat, I don't wear it again. Anytime my coat is taken away from me, I don't wear it a second time. It started from when the father gave him the coat of many colors inside the bush. When the brothers were about selling him to the Midianites, they removed his coat of many colors and he never wore it again. And then when he got to Egypt, they wore him a coat of a slave in the house of Potiphar. Potiphar gave him a coat to become the chief servant, to become a chief slave among other slaves, and Potiphar's wife laid her hands on the coat, and Joseph removed his hands from the coat, and Potiphar's wife took the coat and never wore him the coat anymore. For affliction will never come a second time. Amen. Ladies and gentlemen, something new is about coming to happen to somebody, because you have stepped into a new year. Something new must happen in your life. If you believe me, you will lift your hand and you shout amen. It is time, brother, I prophesy over your head. Every man, every woman hiding under anything to deal with you, 2017 will expose that thing. Can I hear your amen a second time? Can I hear that amen loud and clear right now? Can I hear your amen shake this place? Tell them all. Then Pharaoh sent for him. Ladies and gentlemen, in 2017, I hear God sending for you. You heard my voice in the last minutes of 2016, and you're hearing my voice in the starting minutes of 2017. People of God, brethren, ladies and gentlemen, this is 2017. This is the year for your national and international relevance. This is the year. This is the year. Those that didn't know you before, this is the year they must know you. If you made it to 2017, you must make it in 2017. This is our year of unstoppable rewards. You under this unction and grace, 2017 is a pay year.
Bible believing mission incorporated, the dwelling place of the God of covenant.
Can I touch your hands? Open your hand for me. Say these words with me. Say, they can't finish my family.
They can't finish my family.
Say it loud. Say it loud. Say, they cannot finish my family.
They cannot finish my family.
Can I touch your hand?
Yes, sir.
This is 2017. I came as a prophetic bomb. I'm going to speak into lives tonight. Destinies must receive a turnaround. They want to kill your father too, but they will not succeed.
Amen.
They've killed your mother. She's at the mortuary right now.
Yes.
And they still want to go ahead to kill your father. And what is their interest? They're looking for a way to close up the door of this family. But how can you end a family when God have not ended the family? Can I touch your hands, young man? I carry the prophetic mandate of the God of Tokunadu. I sit in the place of my office this morning, standing upon the call of God over my life, as a messenger of God, and as the one carrying the prophetic mandate of the God of Tokunadu. As I lay my hands on you now, I said, the one who has been doing this wickedness to your family, let him reap what he has sown. Let him rip it. 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 In the name of Jesus Christ. 2017, this case is hereby.
Father, release the wind of glory. The atmosphere for miracle. Oh, Ikukuma Kusanuma.
Sent for Joseph. 2017. Favor is sending for you. Oh, Kalabash! Favor is sending for you. Say, call him, call him, call her, call her. Call him, call him. From this moment, you will receive a favorable visitation. This prophecy will carry you. You will not dodge this prophecy. This prophecy will carry you. You cannot dodge this prophecy. This prophecy will carry you. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Bible believing mission in Popular, the dwelling place of the God of Tokunadu.
This year, anybody who will take your name to a native doctor, anybody who will take your name to any shrine, to any deity, to any wicked altar, to do one harm or the other to you, I stand upon this altar. I say it will not work for that person. Wherever they will take your name to this year, whatever they plan against you will happen to them. Whatever they arrange against you will happen to them. Somebody lift your voice and let me hear your amen. Let me hear your amen. Let me hear your amen. Settle, settle, settle. You looking for your 8 years old son?
Yes, sir.
Since 4 days now.
4 days now.
You've gone everywhere.
Yes,
you've called people. You've been crying. People are celebrating. But your own celebration was cut short because of your son. Look at me, my sister. You want to cry? Look at me. Don't cry. Just look at me. I called you out because God is set to help you. You know what you will do? Don't cry. Wipe your tears. Your son is not lost. Somebody want to deceive your husband. Your husband was the one who sent the person that came to collect your son. And they took your son to him. Where your husband told you he was going was Lagos. But your husband is in Sapele. They went to introduce him to something. And they brought your son to him. He want to use your son for ritual. Because your husband want to make money. As you leave this house next night, don't cry, don't cry. I'm not saying it to you for you to cry. As you leave this house now, pick your phone and call your husband. They've been delaying him because their grandmaster traveled and he's to come back. But tell your husband that Toknadu said, that where he's going, there is no way there. Let him come back with the son. Tell him I said he's with the son. Tell him the house where he is number 17 Upper Erejua. That I said he should come back with the son. And that Toknadu said, they've told him that he will present the son by Monday. Tell him Toknadu said if he present that boy, he, your husband, will be the one to die. But nothing will happen to that boy. This case is hereby settled. Settled. Settled.
Yeah.
Now do what I told you. Can I talk to you?
Yes, sir.
Can I talk to you?
Yes, sir.
This is 2017.
Yes, sir.
You were not the one I called. I called another, but you came. And I decided to look at you. When I looked at you, I saw the padlock with which they locked your womb. Is that the major need in your life?
Yes, sir.
A very big one. It makes noise in your stomach.
I served for 9 years now. I got married. There's no child.
For 9 years. This is 2017.
I know, sir.
Did you hear everything I said about 2017?
I heard it all.
You had it all.
Yes, sir.
I want to show you sample. Come here. This is 1st January 2017. If by February you are not pregnant, I stop preaching. Settle. Settle.
Yahweh, your name is Yahweh. You are the miracle walking God. Your name is Yahweh.
Bible believing mission incorporated, the dwelling place of the God of talk and truth.
2017. Every battle in your life this year, we put an end to that battle, and it will give you victory. By prophecy, I order 2017 to reward you for every investment, for every struggle, for every sacrifice, for every seed, for all your offering, for every service done to Jehovah, 2017 will pay you all. Settle. 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 The Bible said the master
stretched his hands and touched the man that was full of leprosy and declared to him, I am willing that you be healed. And immediately,
thus said the Lord, as surely as I live, declares the Lord, I will do to you the very thing I hear you say. Thus said the God of Tognadu, come, say it, and you will go with the answer.
This case is here.